I'm gonna do Broadway. Hello?
Broadway?
That's how I felt when I auditioned for Rockettes, and they're like, don't call us, we'll call you. And I had just graduated college, and I went through all the things. They took my measurements. Like, the Rockettes audition's really hard. I don't know if y'all have done it. It's hard.
Yeah.
And so the second day, you know, there's only 10 of us left in New York. And
wow.
I was like, and the girl from Fosse, like the Fosse DVD, the girl with the, the brown curly hair,
yeah.
She was auditioning with me. And I was like, she wore the Fosse jacket. And I was like, oh my God, I know them. I was like so excited. And I was like that dancer. I was like, I'm auditioning against her, basically.
Right, yeah.
And why am I like, you're so good.
Yeah.
And I would clap for people. And I was like, oh, maybe don't do it. And like give my friends notes, like, oh, your finger, just so you know, you were little.
Oh, I love you.
I would like totally coach my friends.
But you did great, but you did great.
You did so good. Keep smiling. Yeah, go get it. There's a reason why I didn't get cast. I don't know why. Maybe because when they taught the tap combo, I was like, woo! And then everyone just like looked at me. And I was like, well, I didn't. I guess I think I might have too much personality.
Too much. You might have had a little too
learn.
Much personality.
Wow. But after that audition, the woman taking all our measurements, and the measurements are literally like anything you can imagine,
that's
right?
Crazy.
Like everything.
Wow.
And so I was like, I just wanted to let you know this was my first professional audition, and y'all are so nice.
Where are you from again?
Texas, duh, clearly. And she goes, what's your name? I was like, Catherine Burns. And she was like, no, I'm sure. But I was like, I just outed myself so hard.
That's a classic story. Oh, that's so
y'all
good.
Are so, this is my first audition, first professional audition.
Nice.
Y'all are so nice.
I love it.
But that's amazing that you even, you got that far on your first audition.
But then every
audition.
Time, but I didn't know. Yeah, I was right. It was great.
Yeah.
But I didn't know that they don't let you know. If you're not hired,
right.
If
you're just waiting indefinitely.
Right. I graduated college. I told all my professors I was going to go be a Rockette.
Yeah.
So much for the degree in communication. You know, I'll communicate great. So then every time an out of area number rang, I was like, "Hello, Rockettes." No, I haven't paid that bill. Okay, great. And like, you know, just like living at home waiting for the phone to ring, literally.
Yeah, that's horrible.
Wow.
That's the worst.
Like
it's hard.
Yeah,
it is
not
hard.
Cool.
It's hard
really
to plan.
Did they cast it yet? Okay, great, thanks.
And then now we're so jaded, we're like, psh.
Yeah.
Well, I guess I'll find out when I find out.
Yeah. Exactly.
When that movie comes out and then you're not in it. And you're
exactly.
Oh, I guess I didn't book that job.
Yeah, totally.
Even that commercial, you're like,
yeah.
Okay.
Mm.
Yeah.
I guess that scene looks great. Yeah, sure. It'd have been better with me in it, but whatever. That's besides the point. Yeah, totally.
Well, now look at ya.
Yeah.
Well, so obviously choreographing for Rockettes will be like next up.
Right.
If me and Michaels can do it.
Right. Totally. Totally.
Well, no, and that's Broadway.
Yeah, it's Broadway-ish. Yeah. Broadway adjacent.
Yeah, adjacent.
They love to be referred to as that. Oh, Broadway adjacent? Ooh. Yeah, that's S. Rockettes. No, if they're not.
But really, what is next for you? Or can we?
Well, I'm working on a show called Another Period, which is a really funny, like, mock reality show in 1903, because reality shows, there's no cameras, obviously.
Right.
But they play, like, it's Ricky Lindholm and Natasha Leggero's show.
Uh-huh.
And I've choreographed for them a bunch. Like, the cool thing about comedy, too, is, like, once they know I can, like, deliver on a dance scene, that they keep writing in dance scenes, like, throughout the series.
That's awesome.
So that's kind of how Key & Peele happened. Like, the first season, I did 3 sketches. Uh-huh. But I'd worked with them at UCB and the director, Peter Atencio, and... So, and then it eventually led to like season 5 and I choreographed Negro Town and was like,
that
why did
was
I?
That was an amazing scene though.
Thanks.
Yes.
You know, I cast it well.
Yeah.
I cast like actual Alvin Ailey trained dancers that could like legitimize the movement because Jordan was like, Catherine, what would dancing look like if white people never existed? Well, obviously as the expert,
well,
let me tell you a few things about African jazz. But so I was like, this is gonna be a weird day. Who let her into Negro Town? Oh man,
it was actually fantastic.
Thank you.
It was really
and like,
great.
It's a smartest sketch I've ever seen, to be honest, and poignant and sad. Like it was joyful, but it's very sad.
Right.
And real, but funny.
Yeah.
And sad, but true, but funny.
But funny, all
and
funny.
Beautiful.
My
the dancers
are
living.
Because I'm just like laughing and smiling. It's hilarious. I love it.
Your cheeks look great. How's my mascara? I'm like,
you're not
running.
You're fine. You're fine.
Yeah, you're good.
Yeah, you're so good. Your blush on. Your lips are good. You're
great.
Good.
Yeah. Thanks, Wendy Jones.
Uh-huh.
Wendy was like, do you need some blush? I was like, are you saying I need blush? Fair enough.
Thanks, Wendy. Thanks for making us look pretty.
Thanks. Because it was just makeup in the car on the way here. You know, I don't know if y'all do that.
Work it out.
Only at a stoplight.
Are you kidding? Makeup only happens in the car.
Yeah.
This one. Lashes in the car.
Oh, lashes in the car. That's how I got my first
lashes in the car.
Yeah! Right. Don't do that again.
Yes. I danced in the producers locally, and this is a very La La Land story. I mean, I currently have a green Prius and, like, love to get parking tickets in my car towed, but that's by the point.
Because we live in Franklin Village where there's no parking.
There's no parking.
Don't tell everybody.
But I literally was driving. My address is 2127 Sherman Way. No, I'm just kidding. It's not. But I was driving to rehearsal with my friend in the car. I have a Jeep, had a Jeep Liberty, and I rear-ended a Ferrari. And then at the end of it, I was like, I'm sorry, I'm just late. I'm in the show. I'm in the producers. You can come if you want. I was like, no, I did not.
Yes, you did.
And so, I was like, oh, congratulations. It's so beautiful. My friend's dad just got a Ferrari. And I know really, and like, it was like no license plate. It was that new. And I don't know if you've seen a Ferrari M, but there's not a bumper, which there should. If I had that kind of expensive of a car, I'd have a few bumpers.
Yep.
You know?
A few bumpers, eh?
Oh, man. Yeah. Like, Jeeps have bumpers because they run into things. If I was a Ferrari, I wouldn't be driving in rush hour, by the way.
No. In Los Angeles?
No. And he was doing one of those, you know? So, yeah, just it crumbled. And I was like, I gotta go. I'm gonna be late for my show.
Here's some tickets. Bye.
Do you want to come? Just on me.
Right. Oh, my God.
VIP seats. Row two. Dead center.
So, like, that's, like, the quintessential broke L.A. girl being, like, and everyone just driving past, and the one-on-one was, like,
oh, you're right. Exactly. You, like, yeah. Right. Sobbing. Oh, my goodness. I love it.
But I wasn't doing my lashes.
I'm excited because you've had such an incredible career and you've really managed to kind of navigate through all of them and then utilize everything within your choreography and your work. And I mean, I'm excited to see where you go even from here.
Thank you. I mean, it feels special to, like, because as a dancer, I sometimes felt like I wasn't pretty enough or good enough or sexy enough or too tall or too curvy or whatever. And then studying comedy, I was like I could see the talent and I was with all these really amazingly funny people. The second they walked on stage would get a laugh, you know? And I was like, I just feel like I had these two worlds and people were confused. I was like, as a comedian, they were like, you're a dancer? I was like, yeah. And like, dancer was like, you're funny? And I was like, maybe. And then, but like combining the two and it's been nice. And like, people do have fun, I think, working with me. And like, to me, that's really special to be like, we can work and we can be professional and we can get shit done and we can have a good product. And no one's an asshole. Yeah. We can, at least I won't be, but and I try not to hire assholes because that just ruins. Can you say that on this?
You can tell our viewers like something to that effect that they need
don't
to
be
hear.
An asshole. About just like be nice, because I don't know. I think people can hide. I mean, when someone's intimidatingly mean on purpose or they try to tear people down, it's because they're not comfortable and they're insecure. So for me, just trying to be authentic and like. It's been nice to be known as like the weird, funny one in the dance community. Cause like I have appreciated it for such a long time and I've lived in LA for like 13 years, you know? And it's so funny cause there's always that switch when people are like, girl, I want to work with you. I was like, I've auditioned next to you for years. That always happens. Like the tall girls know each other, you know? And I can see over everybody in every audition, so I remember things. And I'm that person that's like, maybe I was scouting for dancers, you know? Which is true. Like. Even if you don't get that audition, you never know who's auditioning with you, who's impressed. Because I've literally auditioned with other people. And you're really good. I should. Okay. And then eventually, I would use them for something. Because, you know. Remembered. Yeah. And then also having patience, because there are people that I consistently think of, but I don't have something for them.
Right.
And it might be like 2 years later.
Right.
So if someone's like not hiring you, it's not because they don't like you. It's just they're just not. And you never know. Like you can't have two redheads in the mix.
Right.
And, ugh, it's casting is a miracle that anyone gets hired on anything ever. It's very complicated.
It can be political, it can be so many different things. You have no idea what's going on behind the scenes.
Yeah. So when you actually get the job, like enjoy it. Don't be afraid to speak up and say, hey, I think it's, you know, can we have some water or whatever? I mean, I always try, but
yeah,
there's no reason not to be nice.
Right.
Yeah. Exactly. Well, so tell us, because you and Mandy Moore are on the Board of Governors of the Television Academy. Tell us about that, because we try to educate our viewers as much as we can and get them on board and bring awareness.
Awesome.
So, yeah.
So, well, there's a lot of things regarding choreographers that people don't know. Like, so I'm on a TV show, right? You would think, like, I'm, like, rolling in and I choreograph a TV show. No.
The burns.
But we actually, for the most part, unless you can negotiate otherwise, but choreographers don't get health and pension. We're not part of a union. Mm-hmm. So right. There isn't anyone fighting on our behalf other than our agents or other what we personally can negotiate on a contract. So dancers are really well protected. You know, they used to be extras until they fought for that to be separate with SAG. I mean, the SDC, which is the stage directors and choreographers, which eventually will all be a part of Broadway. You know, yeah. They're very well protected and compensated. Mm-hmm. So also choreographers don't own their own work. So Michael Peters, you know, isn't making a payday. Mm-hmm. So every time Happy is airing and that video is airing, I don't make any more money.
Right.
I like just gave it, right. You know, mm-hmm. Which is fine. It is what it is. It's part of the process.
Right.
But what's really cool is that the Television Academy supports us and has given us for the first time ever our own peer group. Before we were underneath directors and they were making all of decisions as far as like for the Emmys, who can be eligible to vote, who should be in the peer group, what makes choreography seem special and different. Like people that weren't dancers, choreographers, artistic directors, or assistants were making all these decisions on behalf of choreographers, which because we are an individualized thing on most sets and like in music videos and everything else, it's like normally just one or two or something. Mm-hmm. It is important that we all kind of come together and support each other.
Yes.
And also like new dancers too that want to be choreographers, understanding and appreciating the like road work and the steps that choreographers are doing to become more unionized and to become more of like a unified front.
Yeah.
Because we have to have each other's backs in an industry that doesn't really understand us. Yeah. Like they don't really know what we do. And we do wardrobe, we help cast,
everything.
We with hair and makeup. We try to like troubleshoot all day long because we know that when it comes time to the dance, and we know that they're gonna, you know, if someone's falling out of a turn or whatever, they might not notice.
Yeah. Yeah.
And if we don't do our like work ahead of time and be prepared to deliver, then it's gonna make our work suffer. Mm-hmm. And you know, for the safety of the dancers, like we have to protect everybody.
Yeah.
Because you know, it's hot out here, full of Pam. You know what I'm saying? Sorry.
Well, that's really great. I really congratulations.
Thank you.
I think that more people need to know about it, know about this, learn about it, and know how they can be involved in one way or another. And we were just talking about sort of the life of a dancer and how it keeps turning over. And so by the time a lot of these, you know, dancers are not even in the industry anymore, and now choreographers need to kind of step in and own their what they're doing, own their work. And even with Dancers Alliance, we were having this conversation earlier that with the younger generation, they don't even know what their rights are, what they should be standing up for, what they should be voicing, you know, their opinions on. And so it's been a struggle, I think, with the younger generation kind of coming into this digital era. And I'm so glad that you represent choreographers.
Thanks, and Mandy and a bunch of people have been helping to make this happen. And, and the Academy's really graciously been like, we want you guys to have a home and a voice and a place that you guys can talk about choreography and And what's cool about joining the Television Academy is that once you're a member, you get to go to all these events. So as like as someone that's a dancer or a choreographer that doesn't really understand all aspects of production, you can go to these panels from experts. Mm-hmm. And it's just like you get so many other benefits. And it's good to be a part of a community and outside of yourself, outside of dance. I mean, because for me, like I will say, like it's hard if your only friends are dancers, right? Who's this is a weird way to say it. Hold on. I wasn't gonna say like who's gonna help you. Like that was weird. If everyone's on your level, who's gonna help you? That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying like dance can be a part of so many different parts of production and life and stuff. And so having writer friends for me, comedic friends, you know, that's helpful. So like opening up our world to not just dance.
Right. Mm-hmm.
To like, oh, who was at audition, who was there, da da da. Like, like expand, make friends. LA is a big place, or New York, wherever you live, you know?
Yeah.
And there's never a reason to like not be curious or inquisitive about something you don't know about, I think is really great for dancers.
Yeah. And learn, I mean, because you don't know where it's gonna lead you, who's gonna be the next person that might bring you into the next project, so. Yeah. And I just have a random question.
Yes, I'm single.
So when you... there it is.
How are
you doing? Catherine!
You know, everyone wants a piece of this now. P.S. She is 5'10". How tall are you?
5'10"? I'm tall. I'm
5'10".
So just... Okay.
What? She's 5'10". Catherine Burns, right here.
Well, I did... Sorry. I just thought it'd be really funny if when I won the Emmy... I was like, yo, mom and dad are here. Let's just bachelorette this shit up real quick if anyone wants to But can you imagine if like someone at an award show was like, hey, I'm single. I'm staying up here on this podium until one of y'all raises your hand to ask me out.
That would be bold, girl.
I know. Love it.
That would be bold.
That would have like Emmy 10. I don't think Emmy 10.
Back to the question.
I just had a question, like, when, because now obviously you're in the position to be casting 360 dancers.
Yeah.
But in general, what do you look for when you're casting? Because your sort of choreography is specific, and it's a body of work that, you know, somebody has to kind of be able to do all that.
Yeah, that's a great question. I mean, so for me, it's important. A few things that, like, if I don't see what I want from a headshot resume, right? Mm-hmm. I'll, like, totally go to their Instagram. If someone's right and I think that they could be right for a project, I'll look at their Instagram, I'll find out other footage. So, like, I think it's important that dancers put work out there, even if it's as cheesy as, like, doing turns in a studio or kicking or whatever. Right. But, like, because, you know, creating your own content is so accessible and important, dancers also need to have pictures of their face that's not all dolled up. Because I can't tell you how many things I choreographed that aren't pretty girls. Uh-huh. Yeah. There are pretty girls too, but they don't want your typical hot, whatever that hot thing is, you know, that like the dance community has a tendency to be like, this is hot and sexy.
Yeah.
What is it called? Body conscious. Like, not every picture needs to be body conscious. I mean, yes, have that. So like, but, and also to know that, like, if you're bigger, if you're not, like, there is a place for that. And so for me, I look also for following instruction, obviously. Mm-hmm. And for me, I cast a lot of actors that dance or dancers that can act and that understand camera. Mm-hmm. So like my friend Megan, who's my assistant as well sometimes, she played the pregnant yoga instructor.
Megan Kong.
Yeah, Megan Kong. Yeah, she's amazing. And she's such, I really like smart dancers.
Yeah.
Like, you can be as talented as a day is long, but if we're here and you're dancing here, like, you're out of the shot.
Right.
What are you doing?
Right.
So Megan was like, because the one moves was this, like, say this is her camera, and she knew she was pregnant. She was like, she just slightly, like, moved
angle.
It.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't tell her, but, like, she knew.
She did.
So, like, I guess understanding what your strengths are and then educating yourself. But, I don't know. There's really no right way. I just think taking class, you know, I look for smart dancers.
Yeah. Basically.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
Or that are so properly authentic to a certain style, right? But if I don't see that, like, in anything, like, how can I cast an Alvin Ailey dancer if I haven't seen them do anything Alvin Ailey-ish? So, like, it's important to let people know what you do and not feel intimidated. Because I feel like what's tricky too, and this happens with me as well, like, a dancer that works a lot might not want to be like, oh, here's this, like, video of me in a leotard and tights doing kicks in a studio. That seems cheesy to me and my peer. My peers might judge me because it's not, like, cool. Or I think in, like, the social media world, we're afraid of seeming authentic. I don't know. There's definitely something here. But, like, a picture
of
your
face.
It's
like break the wall because the reality is there's so much more to than sometimes the facade that people put up, the look, the one thing that they think needs to be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, and
I love that.
I kind of, and a lot of choreographers kind of ask for this sometimes, but they want a recent selfie. That's not a dolled up headshot
that's
from 5 years ago.
Right.
It's not like full bead. It's just like, this is what I look like if maybe I just woke up or something.
Yeah.
Right. And also to, like, not lie about your height or size.
Right.
For me, because I don't know, as a dancer, I was like, y'all want 5'10 because I'm 5'10.
Yeah.
Like, you're going to find out sooner or later how tall I am.
Yeah.
And with heels?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And, like,
yeah.
Yeah. So exactly. A lot of people will be like, their headshot and resume or say something and you see them in person, you're like, No. So
smart dancers and no
assholes. And no assholes.
And authenticity. Authenticity.
I mean, I mean, you will find out.
Yeah.
Like, just also not just kind to me.
Yeah.
Don't be kind to the person that hires you. Be kind to everyone else.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. I agree. I love it. Well, you are amazing.
Aww,
and you were just a blast to have on the show. Thank you so much for coming and joining us and just dishing
making us
on
laugh.
Everything. Exactly. My cheeks are a little. Yeah, so thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. I wanted to say, I forgot. Yes. There's this really funny show called Teachers on TV Land.
Oh, yes.
And these ladies are awesome. They're called the Katydids from Chicago. Mm-hmm. And just like Rachel, like, they star and create and write. And they have an episode coming up that's all a musical. It's Lunch the Musical, and I choreographed it. And they're just awesome, and people should know about their
show.
What
network?
TV Land.
TV Land.
TV Land.
Teachers.
Teachers. So many good things to look out for.
Yeah.
Hilarious.
We could go on tangents and a tangents and a tangent.
I know, sorry.
No, it's great. It's fun.
Yeah. I can we go can do on it tangents.
Too. No, we can too. Thank you so
yes.
much.
Thank you. Did I do all the things I was supposed to? I don't know.
Yes. Yeah, no, I think you hit all the points. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, was there anything else that you wanted to do or say specifically?
Tell me what?
The musical.
Launch the musical? Bulimia the musical.
Did you want to add that in?
Oh, if you guys want.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a whole different.
Cut and like, yeah. Oh, well, that goes with when you were, we were talking about, you're like, when we can see you every.
Oh, quick and funny. Funny. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Wait, but bulimia is different.
Bonus.
No, so for Quick and Funny Musicals is the show that I do at UCB
right.
all the time.
Yeah.
But then we made we made one of the musicals into a short film.
Ooh.
Bulimia the Musical.
Oh.
And
I
played Nancy, the picture perfect purger, who
picture perfect purger.
Who was sent away to a fat camp called Camp I Don't Want to Eat.
Wow.
And then we say. So.
Wait, where can I watch this?
YouTube.
YouTube.
It's this new device.
What is it?
YouTube.
It's not actually a device. It's just a website.
Right. Oh, okay.
And it's all over the world.
What? Wow. That's crazy. YouTube.
You with a
Y-O-U.
Why? Okay, so not just letter U.
Like tube, like the TV, like a
Y-O-U,
tube.
Y-O-U-Tube.
Got it.
And then I can
find
Bulimia.
I think it's on YouTube. Oh, it's very, very silly. I mean, I co-wrote it and star and like choreographed. And it was just nuts. It's a very taboo subject.
Yeah.
Everyone's a little bit, you know, has some kind of body issue. We all do, let's be honest.
Yeah.
And so, but there's all, for me, like the joy of comedy is not, we weren't poking fun of eating disorders, we were like living it. Like the girl I co-wrote it with, like we actually use a lot of her specifics of her life and her struggle. And like things she learned in her sorority house was, which was an example is like spraying Windex on your bagel, then you won't eat it.
What?
I mean, it's funny, but it's true.
Right.
Because, you know, we've all had a phase or something.
Yeah.
But for me, the joy of comedy is laughing about it.
Exactly.
You know?
Well, it's so ironic because I think, you know, comedy is such an important part of life in general.
Yes.
We need an outlet. We need to laugh. And especially in times like this now, and everything's so political and everything's so sensitive. You got to be careful. Censorship, what you're talking about, what you're doing. But, like, the reality is it's needed. So I love what you're doing.
Thanks.
Like killing it. Killing it. Girl. Yeah.
One day at a time, you know?
Right.
Damn. My hands are freezing.
Ba-da.
Ba-da. Oh, wait, you want to see my double high five?
Yeah.
Okay, wait, I just ruined it. Okay, shoot.
Double high five.
Well, high five me.
Oh.
Ow.
Oh, ow.
I was not ready for that.
Ready? I'm going to have choreography. She's choreography.
You gotta, yes. But I also just,
tuck it and Vogue.
I got to Vogue on, there's a show called Throwing Shade.
Ooh,
on TV Land.
Oh,
careful.
Yeah.
But I actually got to hire like House of Ninja. Like someone's like, we want Vogue. I was like, got it. House of Ninja, please Vogue with me.
Yes.
So, like they're really proper House
the
of Ninja.
Deal. I love it.
Eric and Carlos.
And that's another thing too that I love. I love that you always bring the authenticity of to the choreography, whether it's the Bali, you know, Bollywood
yoga.
And then, you know, voguing. They all have very specific styles and you do need to be trained. I mean, you can't just lie and say you're an Avanelli dancer. You specifically are I need to know that you are
the
really
the joy of a choreographer is I get to educate myself.
Yes.
Do my research. But they appreciated it. Carlos was like, I know, it comes from like reading and you read someone and they and it's from Harlem, the house, and then I know the boys didn't have homes. Like I get to like educate myself on all these amazing facets of dance and then bring them to light through comedy. Yeah.
But you're the connector, so that's what's fantastic.
I'm such a connector. Yes. I'm so Breaking Bad.
You're so
bad. Isn't that like a bad thing, so if someone's a connector, they're a...
It's a good thing.
No,
I
like the connection you do.
Yeah, like a good comedy dance is a good connection.
Yeah.
I mean, it's fun.
Yeah.
It's a great way to live. Laugh and dance.
I love it.
Laugh and dance.
I'm coming to your show.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, please do it tomorrow.
Okay.
We have a musical about Donald Trump. We're doing a whole jukebox musical where you take existing music. Like, you know jukebox musicals are a thing, right?
Yeah.
Like Mamma Mia. It's a jukebox musical, right?
Yeah.
Abba.
Abba,
yes. Thank you. So we're doing Papa Pia. Which is really dumb. Papa Pia, a girl tries to find her dad, that's what we're doing. And then Mary-Kate and Ashley Olsen have an album, but we made it about the White House. So there's a song like, no one tells the president what to do. And then there's I wanna have a pinata party. So imagine. And then, let's see, do Dracula, Count Dracula.
Oh,
I play Paris Hilton.
Oh. Ooh, that's hot.
Uh-huh, I do a rap. I'm not a very good rap. I'm not a very good rapper, but I tried.
I don't think Paris can rap anyway.
Right.
I can't wait to hear
She can't rap.
Yeah.
Whatever. And then she's apparently a good DJ. Yeah. Who knew?
Everybody's a DJ now, right?
Yeah. Well, she apparently educated herself. I don't know. We're not friends. Sure. I don't know her.
Okay, so you basically can DJ, choreograph, dance, act, sing.
Can't DJ. Can't DJ.
But no DJing.
I can play a DJ.
Right.
You can play a DJ, but you can't really DJ.
Right.
Yeah.
It's all good.
That's all you need.
But it's important to like have slashes. You know, I'm like, if you gotta be a slash.
Slashes.
Sorry, you know what I mean?
Suicide slash.
Catherine.
Yeah.
Cat Burns. Slash dancer. Slash choreographer. Slash actor. Slash
comedian.
Slash singer.
Slash single.
What?
Slash. No, it's fine.
It's okay. We share that.
It's okay. I'm dying alone with my cats. I have two cats.
I have a dog.
Well,
that's all. Oh yeah, that's what.
I have a dog. You have a cat.
Thank you.
Did she tell you how she was like, wait, I know you lived here because when you won the Emmy, your friends drew on your sidewalk.
Oh, really?
And they were like, Capper! Like literally
they giant
along the entire like sidewalk.
And this is like a popular area where people park their cars and walk to whatever.
Yeah. Yep.
And they took up the whole.
And like neon yellow.
My friend Mackenzie,
chalk.
I love her. God bless her. Was very cute.
Yeah.
But I was like, oh, I feel very.
Because now everyone knows where you live.
But you know what's also hello. So funny? You don't even know this.
Oh God.
I'm gonna sound like a Cat Burns stalker.
Yes.
Okay, so I'm gonna confess my stalkerness. So when I moved into the neighborhood, and that night that you won the Emmy, I happened to be walking back on my sidewalk. Back home after I packed my car, and I saw your proud mother and father and whomever else you were with, and you and your dad proudly held the Emmy and was like, yeah! And then you were like, stop it, Dad! I saw all of you guys coming back from the Emmy, and I was like, I didn't know at the time, so I was like, that's cool, that chick just won an Emmy and kept on right on walking.
Didn't realize.
I'm like,
Barbie,
you're funny. Gonna use this one on your next episode.
Yeah, right,
exactly.
But so, yeah, so that's along awesome. With you just seeing that whole picture, I saw the aww. Sidewalk and I was like, oh, was I'm Cat really Burns' neighbor.
Yeah, Cat Burns' neighbor. Yeah. You didn't know, she won a fucking Emmy, that's what she put. She won a fucking Emmy, and then it was like arrows to my place, and
oh
then
my
like
God.
My name's like, we love you.
Just going up the stairs.
Yeah. Hopscotch leading to your door.
Yeah, so yeah. sweet. Totally. I was like, I'm gonna, like,
those
people
cute.
Are gonna hate me.
Oh my God.
No, we love it.
And it stayed until it rained, which was a while.
It was a while. No, it was a while.
It was there
that,
for a
whatever
while.
Whatever that street
I mean, I could have cleaned it up, but I'm too lazy.
Yeah.
Don't worry. My dog probably peed on
it.
Oh,
it also made me happy. Oh, yeah, great. Yeah.
She was like,
this is super bonus.
Sorry.
Bonus. And
don't
then
let
the
us
bonus
keep going.
The bonus.
We will keep going.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yay.
Isn't that cute, thank though?
That's amazing. No, it was
we went
so
to La
cute.
Poubelle. We were driving.
Yeah.
I've been going to La Poubelle since I moved to L.A. But obviously, I live in North Hollywood, so that was like a very long walk.
Yeah.
No, Sherman Way, right? Sherman Way.
Yeah. Okay.